Kiruhura and Kisoro district leaders are worried that the country might lose out on most of the tourists because of the poor roads leading to the tourist sites in most parts of the country. Speaking to journalists at the Uganda Media Center in Kampala, the district chairperson for Kisoro, Abel Biziman, expressed concern that up to date, government has not taken any steps to construct the road from Kisoro leading to Windi National Park. Yet it's one of the major tourism sites that bring in a number of tourists and revenue.
What is going to the national parks, how the private sector is supported, how communities that need to protect these environments have benefited from industry. You can wonder whether really we need to first go elsewhere other than here in Rwanda to learn the best practices. So on accommodation, it's purely private. But again, they are frustrated by rules against them. You find that it's very hard to acquire land, for example. If you really give incentives to people in industries, I hear the Turkish have 18 miles of land in Ruero for tourism. Government has land in these districts. Why can't these people in tourism industry also get free land from government, and they put hotels and put their bars and put there those things that tourists like? You'll find someone struggling.
Bizimana insists that trade and security as well as roads also need to be considered.
Government stops scavenging on tourism because it needs it most. It is only the heart that is selfish before it supports the rest of the body. It produces the first blood vessel called coronary artery to feed itself before it feeds the rest of the body. So we must force government to make sure tourism industry first feeds itself before it feeds anybody else.
In 2021, the government committed to work on infrastructure with a focus on the construction of roads that will turn Uganda into one of the leading tourism destinations in Africa. But unfortunately, this has not yet been fully achieved.
If local governments retain a percentage to work on the road, but I am not definite on that. I am only here representing a minister, but it's a proposal that can be looked at. I can only tell you that on behalf of Parliament and government, that tourism roads together with security roads take the first priority.
These leaders are also advocating for the increment of the percentage of the revenue which the government allocates to the tourism districts.
Another thing we have seen, the central government is so desperate for tax that they are exposing people and wild to hazards. For example, as a public health specialist, if you see how many products of things that are supposed to be swallowed as beverages. I don't want to mention those companies, I don't go to court. But humans are now swallowing so many things in the names of strengthening manhood, in the names of whatever, so many adverts, but surely, Uganda National Bureau of Standards, are these things worse for human consumption?
Failure to pay attention to the tourism sector is threatening to derail the attempts to increase the number of tourists coming into the country. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.